প্রিয় ছাত্রছাত্রীরা, আশা করি তোমরা সবাই সুস্থ আছো, বাড়িতে বসে মন দিয়ে পড়াশোনা করছো। তোমাদের অনুরোধে আজকে আমি এই ভিডিও ক্লাসটা নিচ্ছি। যদিও সাইটোস্কেলিটন একটা বিশাল চ্যাপ্টার, তাও আমি চেষ্টা করব যতটা সম্ভব সবটাই কভার করতে। তোমরা এটা শুনতে গেলে তোমাদের মনে যেখানে যদি কোনো প্রশ্ন হয় সেটা নোট করে রাখবে। প্রশ্নগুলো আমাকে ডিপার্টমেন্টাল মেলে পাঠিয়েও আমি নিশ্চয়ই তার উত্তর দেবার চেষ্টা করব। ঠিক আছে, তাহলে আমি একবার আমাদের টপিকে চলে যাই। ডেফিনিশন অফ সাইটোস্কেলিটন: দ্য নেটওয়ার্ক অফ প্রোটিন ফিলামেন্টস অ্যান্ড মাইক্রোটিউবলস ইন দ্য সাইটোপ্লাজম দ্যাট কন্ট্রোলস সেল শেপ, মেনটেন্স ইন্টারসেলুলার অর্গানাইজেশন অ্যান্ড ইজ ইনভলভড ইন সেল মুভমেন্ট। নেক্সট, দ্য সাইটোস্কেলিটন। আচ্ছা, সাইটোস্কেলিটন বলতে আমরা কি বুঝি? আমরা স্কেলিটন জানি, যেটা কঙ্কাল, অন্তঃকঙ্কাল, যে বডিটাকে একটা সাপোর্ট দেয় সেটাকে আমরা বলি স্কেলিটন। এবার সাইটোস্কেলিটনের কাজ কি? সেও আমাদের যে কি আছে সাইটোপ্লাজমটাকে সাপোর্ট দেওয়ার জন্য, তো আমাদের কিছু ফাইবার্স দরকার লাগে নিশ্চয়ই, তবেই তো আমরা সেল স্ট্রাকচারটা ঠিকভাবে দাঁড়াতে পারবে। সাইটোস্কেলিটনের কাজও তাই। সাইটোস্কেলিটন কি করে? ইট প্রোভাইড সাপোর্ট ইন আ সেল। ইট ইজ আ নেটওয়ার্ক অফ প্রোটিন ফাইবার্স সাপোর্টিং সেল শেপ অ্যান্ড অ্যাঙ্কারিং অর্গানেলিজ উইদিন দ্য সেল। দ্য থ্রি মেইন স্ট্রাকচারাল কম্পোনেন্টস অফ সাইটোস্কেলিটন আর মাইক্রোটিউবলস ফর্মড বাই টিউবুলিনস, মাইক্রোফিলামেন্টস ফর্মড বাই অ্যাক্টিনস অ্যান্ড ইন্টারমিডিয়েট ফিলামেন্টস। ফাইনালি ইট অলসো অ্যাসিস্ট ইন মুভিং মেটিরিয়ালস ইন অ্যান্ড আউট অফ দ্য সেল। আচ্ছা, প্রথমে আমরা এই স্ট্রাকচারটা দেখি। এইখানে আমরা কি দেখছি? দ্য অ্যাক্টিন, দিজ আর দ্য মাইক্রোফিলামেন্টস, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য অ্যাক্টিন ফিলামেন্টস। অ্যাক্টিন, দিজ গ্লোবিউলস, দিজ আর দ্য জি অ্যাক্টিনস অ্যান্ড দে টোটালি দে ফর্ম দ্য এফ অ্যাক্টিন ফিলামেন্ট। দিট ইজ দ্য থিনেস্ট ফিলামেন্ট দ্যাট উই ফাইন্ড ইন দ্য সাইটোস্কেলিটন অ্যান্ড ইটস ডায়ামিটার ইজ অ্যাবাউট 7 ন্যানোমিটার ইন ডায়ামিটার। And these are the microtubule. This is the thickest filament. As you see, this is the microtubule. Its diameter is 25 nanometer in diameter. Here it is made up of two types of tubulin, the alpha and the beta tubulin. I'll come to it later. And this is the intermediate filament. These intermediate filament, it is known intermediate because its diameter is between these two, the actin filament and the microtubules. Its diameter is about 8 to 12, that is about 10 nanometer in diameter. And these three structures, they support the cell like this. Here you can see that this is the filaments, the microfilaments, these are the microtubules, and these are the intermediate filaments which helps in attaching these filaments and maintaining the shape of the cell. Here we can see that when you see the microtubules, these are the microtubules here at the time of chromosome separation. You can see the tubules, the asters, these are all made up of microtubules, and the linings, the surface, this is made up of microfilament. Now we come, not all eukaryotes but also prokaryotes possess a cytoskeleton. Tubulin related bacterial protein FTSZ and actin related bacterial proteins MREB or MBL have recently been described as constituents of bacterial cytoskeleton. Now we come to the first filament, that is the microfilaments. Microfilaments or actin filaments are the thinnest filament of the cytoskeleton and are found in the cytoplasm of eukaryotic cells. The polymers of these linear filaments are flexible but still strong, resisting crushing and buckling while providing support to the cell. Microfilaments are fine thread-like protein fibers, 3 to 6 or even above 7 nanometer in diameter. They are composed predominantly of a contractile protein called actin, which is the most abundant cellular protein. Many microfilaments are found in muscle tissue. They are called myofibrils when found in muscles. The two proteins, myosin and actin, work together to help the muscle cells relax and contract. Edward David Korn discovered microfilament in 1968 in Acanthamoeba castellani. Now this is the structure. Here what I have said in the muscle fibers, this is the myosin and this is the actin filament. The actin filament is the thinnest, myosin is thicker than actin. And these actin and myosin filaments, they form a cross-linking and helps in sliding movement. As we see in the case of amoeba, the pseudopodia comes out, it crawls, and these are done by the help of these actin and the myosin. What happens, this myosin, here they have the meromyosin. It is divided into two parts, that is the head part and the tail part. The meromyosin heavy part and the light part, they say. The heavy part, that is the head part of the meromyosin, it gets attached to the actin filament. And this only happens when calcium level is high here and the ATP is present, which gives energy. Now, in the presence of calcium and ATP, this head of myosin, that is the heavy meromyosin, it gets attached to the actin filament. And this drags the filament. When it drags, it it comes aside, and then the myosin, when the calcium level falls and ATP is also falls, then it the connection gets disconnected. The link, it is not linked again, and it comes back to the usual position. Then again, the thing happens, and like this the sliding movement goes on. In one thing here, what we see, this is the Z lines and the M line. These filaments, these are made up of intermediate filaments. These are not the microfilaments. The actin and myosin are the microfilaments, and like this process, this helps in the movement of the muscle. Now the function of microfilaments. The intracellular transport by cyclosis. Intracellular substances are transported from one part of the cytoplasm to the other by the cytoplasmic streaming movement or cyclosis. And cell movements by microfilaments, that the cells may crawl over the surface. As I said, in case of amoeba, when the pseudopodia it crawls, it takes part with the help of these microfilaments. Now we come to microtubules. As I said, microtubule is the largest filament, the thickest filament. Microtubules provide cell shape and structure, aid in transport within the cell, help in cell division, and drive cell movement by flagella or cilia. Microtubules are the largest cytoskeleton filaments in cells. They have a diameter 25 nanometer. They are made up of subunits called tubulin. Each tubulin subunit is made up of one alpha and one beta tubulin. As I've showed you previously, there are the two tubulin molecules that are attached to each other. So technically, tubulin is a heterodimer, not a monomer. Microtubules play a role in the migration of chromosomes to opposite ends of a mitotic cell. As I've shown you there, that it helps the chromosomes to push to the both the ends. And there are different types of microtubules which help. I'm coming later. That is, the mitotic spindle is composed of three distinct types of microtubule fibers. One is the kinetochore microtubules, polar microtubules, and aster microtubules. As the polar microtubules, they drag the chromosomes towards the poles, and the aster microtubules are present in the asters, all emanating from the centrosomes. And they serve to pull and push the sister chromatids apart towards the opposite sides, as we see in the case of anaphase, telophase, that the chromosomes are shifted towards the pole. These are done by the microtubules. Beyond the role they play in internal cell movement, microtubules also work together to form large structures that work on the outside of the cells. They can combine in very specific arrangement to form cilia and flagella. As we see in case of euglena, paramecium, and all in the ciliates, Cilia and flagellate is made up of microtubules, which helps in locomotion. The arms, spokes and links hold microtubules together and allow interaction between them. Now, this is the structure of the microtubule, which we find in cilia and flagella. This is a sectional view of the microtubule. It is under the electron microscope. We can see here what we see. These are in doublets. These are the tubulin filaments. This is the alpha tubulin and the beta tubulin, or A tubulin or B tubulin, whatever you say. The alpha one is the full ring, and this is the beta one is the half ring. And this we can see here the dynein fibers, three in the outer side and two in the inner side, which helps in the movement of the cilia. And this green line, this is the nexin protein, which we find which interconnect the tubulins. These are interconnected by the nexin protein. And here the radial spokes are found in the alpha tubulin. This is the structure. Here there are nine doublets. You can see there are nine doublets, and in the center is the central microtubule, single central microtubule, two microtubules are present. This is a structure similar in cilia and in flagella. But cilia and flagella, they're attached to the basal body. When you see the structure of the basal body, there the microtubules are found in triplets, and there the dynein fibers are not found, and the central tubules are also not found, but they remain in triplets in the basal body. But in the whole body, we get this type of a doublet structure of the microtubule. Now, the protofilaments, which are composed of head to tail array of tubulin dimers, are arranged in parallel. Consequently, microtubules are polar structures with two distinct ends, a fast growing plus end and a slow growing minus end. There are two ends, the plus ends, what we say, that is the fast growing end, and the minus end is the slow growing end. Structurally, they are linear polymers of tubulin, which is a globular protein. The function of the microtubules is a mechanical function, cell membrane movement, movement of cilia and flagella, chromosomal movement during cell division, circulation and transport, morphogenesis. It may be involved in converting stimuli into nerve impulses. Now, the intermediate filament. Intermediate filaments, the group of Howard Halster in 1968 discovered intermediate filament, a class of usually insoluble cellular protein fibers. These are the insoluble cellular protein fibers, which helps in connecting the microtubules and the microfilaments to form the cell structure. These are composed of various fibrous polypeptides that serve specially to provide structural stability and strength to the cytoskeleton, and are intermediate in diameter between microfilaments and microtubules. The functions are primarily mechanical, and as a class, intermediate filaments are less dynamic than actin filament and microtubules. They commonly work in tandem with microtubules, providing strength and support for the fragile tubule structures. Unlike microfilaments and microtubules, intermediate filaments do not participate in cell motility. Now, as I've said previously, that their diameter is from 8 to 10, intermediate to the microtubules and the microfilaments. So they are known as the intermediate filaments. Intermediate filaments, together with microtubules and microfilaments, built up the cytoskeleton of most eukaryotic cells. The cytoplasmic intermediate filaments form a dense filament network radiating from the nucleus and extending to the plasma membrane. The different types of intermediate filaments are keratin filaments in epithelial cells, neurofilaments in nerve cells, glial filaments throughout the cytoplasm of astrocytes, vimentin filaments in connective tissue cells, muscle cells and supporting cells of nervous system. Heterogeneous filaments contain different proteins such as desmin and cynein found in skeletal muscles. Now, these are the differences in microfilaments, microtubules and the intermediate filaments. As you can see here, this is the structure. Here you can see this is the microfilaments, this is the microtubules, and these are the intermediate filaments. here in the cell structure, it is so oriented. This green color, these are the microtubules, and this the boundary walls, these are the microfilaments, and these are interconnected by the intermediate filaments. So the cell structure is formed due to these filaments. It remains, gets that shape, the correct shape and size. Thank you.